Sodom and Gomorrah. Dear friends, in the previous story, didn't we tell you that three men came to Abraham and he offered them food to eat? Today we will see who these men were and why they were there. After eating food, they asked where Sarah was and said, "This time next year when I return, Sarah will have a son." Now Sarah was listening at the entrance of the tent which was behind Abraham. Sarah laughed to herself because she thought that it is impossible as she was old. When the men got up to leave, they looked down towards Sodom, and Abraham walked along with them to see them on their way. One of those three men was God Almighty. The Lord was not able to hide from Abraham what he was about to do. Because the people of Sodom and Gomorrah were wicked and great sinners, the outcry against them was great. So the Lord decided to destroy those cities. Afraid that Lot might be destroyed as well, Abraham asked the Lord, "Will you sweep away the righteous with the wicked? What if there are 50 righteous people in the city?" The Lord said, "If I find 50 righteous people in the city, I will spare the whole place for their sake." Then Abraham spoke again, "What if the number of the righteous is far less than 50? Will you destroy the city because of 5 people?" "No, if I find 45 there," the Lord said, "I will not destroy it." But Abraham felt that there would not be 45 righteous people. So he spoke again, "What if only 40 are found there? Or what if only 30? Or even lesser, only 20 are found?" Then he said, "May the Lord not be angry, but let me speak just once more. What if only 10 can be found there?" He answered, "For the sake of 10, I will not destroy it." When the Lord finished speaking with Abraham, he left, and Abraham returned home. The two angels arrived in Sodom in the evening, and Lot was sitting in the gateway of the city. When he saw them, he got up to meet them and bowed down with his face to the ground. And he insisted that they come and spend the night in his house. At first they refused, but eventually they went with him, and he prepared a meal for them. But before they went to bed, all the men of Sodom came to attack them. When Lot refused to hand over the men to them, they kept bringing pressure on Lot and tried to break the door. But the men inside reached out and pulled Lot back into the house and shut the door. Then they struck the men who were at the door of the house with blindness, so that they could not find the door. They revealed the purpose of their coming. They asked Lot to gather the people who belonged to him and escape. So Lot went out and spoke to his sons-in-law, who had pledged to marry his daughters. But his sons-in-law thought he was joking, so they ignored him. With the coming of dawn, the angels held Lot's hand and the hands of his wife and his two daughters and led them out of the city. They said, "Flee for your lives and don't look back." Lot ran to a nearby town, but Lot's wife looked back and she became a pillar of salt. As soon as Lot reached the town, the Lord rained down burning sulfur on Sodom and Gomorrah. Even though the Lord could not find 10 righteous people in the city, he saved Lot for Abraham's sake. We will see if the Lord fulfilled the promise he made to Abraham in the next story. God bless you.